think it's just hard for me to see the love in it. You know,
yeah. Like, you know what?
Are you thinking about the baby at all? Are you? Is the baby even in your concept of that's a person being murdered?
No, absolutely. Yeah.
Okay. So
all the aborted babies, we could have had cancer cured. We could have, like, you know, that child has purpose.
Right.
You know, and God's purpose is for it to be aborted.
So how are you loving that child? And you guys are against abortion. How are you loving the children that are being murdered? I guess that's what I would ask you.
I loving the mom, just thinking of that, praying.
Right. So, like, if a murderer was coming to kill me, you're loving the murderer. So how are you loving me, who's going to be murdered?
The world is sleeping in the dark that the church just can't fight, 'cause it's asleep in the light.
Are you guys recording everything?
Yeah.
Okay.
What do you guys think?
It's a pretty intense photo.
It is.
For lots of children being around.
It is. It is. What do you think about abortion?
I don't agree with it.
Okay.
But I don't agree with this either.
How come you don't agree with abortion?
Because it's a life and it has purpose.
It's a life and they're killing him, right?
Totally.
Okay. 100%. I hate this picture. I don't think anyone should have to look at it.
Yeah.
But today in our nation, 3,500 babies were slaughtered.
Yeah.
Oh, 3,500 and every day. So the context, all I'm saying is the context. I believe that not standing up to end abortion is more evil than standing up to end abortion. Right. So showing this, like, I hate that any children have to see it. My children see this. Yeah. I hate that.
But
I want to end it so I don't have to show it anymore.
Can I ask you what effect you're looking for this picture? Like, what response from the public?
Well,
it's a harsh picture. Like, I think there's different ways to talk about it. Like, promoting adoption and other ways rather than showing the horrific.
Well, reporting, adoption is great. I support it. Every Christian should adopt. Awesome. And it's great. But adoption doesn't actually fight abortion.
Yeah.
It doesn't end in abortion. It's a child that lives gets to have a home, and God has adopted us all as children.
Let's join together right now and pray about this situation. Can we do that? Can we pray for the people who have been through this and the people who are trying to decide what to do, just that God will give them wisdom?
So, hold on. Would you? Most people don't. My name is Danny. What's yours?
Danny, I'm Allison.
Allison, nice to meet you. Most people, like what you just mentioned, like, can we pray about the people deciding this? Can we pray about the issue and the culture? And a lot of people leave out, like, what about the children that are being murdered, you know? Like, we don't think about them, but they're our neighbor. They're our unborn neighbor. And so a lot of us are too busy to care for our unborn neighbor. And it's, like, tacky. Like, I don't want to carry a dead baby around. But what are you going to do? You know? I can affect thousands of people tonight and show them the truth. Well, the first thing is we're showing the truth. And Ephesians 5:11 says, take no part in the evil deeds of darkness, but rather expose them.
But don't you think this is condemning them?
Condemning them of what? I'm not condemning them. They are,
this
like,
is a very
like,
condemning picture.
To who?
To people who have been through this.
Right, well, now, should they be condemned?
No.
The law of God condemns them. It says, thou shalt not murder. And so the law of God actually condemns someone. Jesus says, I didn't come into the world to condemn the world, right? And then he says, why? He says, I didn't come into the world to condemn the world because everyone who doesn't believe stands condemned already. So he didn't condemn anybody because they're already condemned. The law has condemned all. So when a mom who's had an abortion sees this image, the right response is to be guilty. That's the right response. I had a mom, I was at the abortion clinic this morning, and this woman, she came up, she must have been in her 50s, maybe 60s, bawling. When I was 16, I had an abortion and I never forgot it, and don't do it, and she's just crying her tears out. And I asked her, I said, have you told your children this? Have you shared this? No, I would never tell. I said, they're gonna go through the same evil that you've gone through because you won't talk about it. And when Christ, are you Christian? I'm assuming you're Christian. Okay. When Christ sets us free, the whole point, sorry, train of thought. When Christ sets us free, he says us free not to just be, you know, we're just like, thanks Jesus, woo, we're saved. But he says, go. He says, all authority in heaven and earth and mine out there for go. And we're to stand up, greatest command, stand up for our neighbor. Love God and love our neighbor, right? That's the greatest command. So our neighbors are being murdered 3,500 times a day. Yeah, shoot.
Do you think that communicates love to people?
The baby right there is being loved, because that baby is who I'm loving. I'm loving my neighbor right there, and it does communicate love in that I'm giving people the opportunity to repent.
You only get people to give their opinion.
Because they're getting convicted. They're getting convicted of their sin. That's what's condemning them. I'm not condemning them. I don't feel condemned when I look at that picture, because my sins are forgiven. I walk in newness of life. But those that are guilty and still wear that guilt, they are convicted. And that's right. That's what the law is there for. And our conviction should lead us to Christ. Right? I mean, that's the point of the law, is to convict us, to make everybody guilty under the law, so that we'll see we need a Savior, right? You understand? Okay, cool. All the people sinking down. Here, can I challenge you guys to do something? Real quick, I have this idea. I'll give you one of these. What you want? Everybody can have one, but here's a challenge I have for people. Any Christian I meet, I challenge them with. It's a simple challenge. If you have a Bible that has red letters, where Jesus' words, you have that? Okay. A few years ago, everybody talks about Jesus. They're like, well, you know, Jesus wouldn't do that. Jesus wouldn't do this. And I'm like, I'm going to go read what the guy says, right? So I just, in a sitting, read all of Jesus' words. And I'm not going to tell you what I mean, it was convicting to me, but read his words, just his words in one sitting, and ask yourself, is that the Jesus you're following?
Can
you
be so numb? I have a question.
Yeah.
Abolitionist organization, or I don't know what it's called. Abolitionist movement.
Yeah.
Abolish human abortion.
Do you guys have anything to like help people?
Yes.
Yeah.
Like make good decisions, just like practical things.
Well, this helps people make a good decision.
Because, like, I've been thinking about having an abortion. Like, I don't know what else to do. Hey, Ben.
My husband started going to the Planned Parenthood to be a sidewalk counselor out there, and he realized that one day when two women turned away from having an abortion, that he was there to help. And from that point,
that's what I'm saying. Like, if you're telling people, they're gonna, like, what positive resources do you have to give? Like,
anyone can ask us.
What he started doing was getting a list of people who are willing to adopt the babies. If the women turn away from Planned Parenthood, he said, we want Christian homes available for those babies to go to. That mom can surrender the baby and have that baby go to. So that's what we've done. We're ready to take a baby ourselves. That's what we can do. We've got the body of Christ. The body of Christ has to be willing to take care of the widows and the orphans. And these are orphans. And we need to be ready to help the women that have a need. Being there with the gospel of Christ is the biggest help that you can have for that person. But women who go through abortions have high rates of depression, high rates of suicide.
Give you guys hugs. I'm heading out.
All right.
Is that cool?
What's up, man?
Oh, man, you guys have a good day, right?
I love this guy.
No. Nice to meet you guys, though. Ben, by the way, I'm sorry.
Kathy?
Yeah. Danny.
Danny?
Yeah, nice to meet you.
All right, you guys have a good day.
All right, you too.
See you guys.
So the good thing that we leave with is if we save one life, we save a whole world. We save that child and every generation who comes from that child.
What's your typical response, like, for people, you know, like...
Nasty words.
All over the board.
We had a lady earlier that came up and she said that there was somebody in our face that was being very abrasive, and a lady walked up and she said, the next person you talk to, tell them that you just talked to a 68-year-old woman who at 62 found out that her mother tried to abort her multiple times and was unsuccessful. And the only reason that I was not aborted was because someone was really straightforward and finally talked her out of it. Somebody was very abrasive because everybody was asking.
I think it's just hard for me to see the love in it, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you know what?
I'm loving the mom thinking of that, right?
Right. So, like, if a murderer was coming to kill me, you're loving the murderer. So how are you loving me, who's going to be murdered?
I think you guys are really awesome for, like, standing up for what you believe in and being out here. Like, this is super bold, and I just bless you guys in that. I just, like, wanted to hear more from you guys about what it means for you to, like, do this.
I think the biggest thing is it said that we're supposed to watch out for the orphans and the widows.
Yeah.
As soon as the mother decides that she does not want that child, they become an orphan because they're unwanted.
We're supposed to love everybody, too.
We do love everybody.
Yeah.
Well, the mother, a murderer, if you stop a murderer from committing murder, you're loving him. Okay? Because that's not good. Can I give you guys a comparison?
Star, like, would you carry a sign out here saying, I watched
pornography? I'm an adulterer. I'm a murderer.
I've considered abortion.
You know, like, I just feel like this is just one way of, like, this is just one.
I guess maybe it is one evil.
Maybe you could have a different sign.
I'm sorry. Will you forgive us if we've offended you at all?
You haven't offended us. I appreciate it. You've come and you've asked us, and we're doing the best we can.
Awesome. You gotta start somewhere.
It's way radical. Hard to swallow.
You know, one thing I wanted to say to you, though, and it took me a while to swallow this, too, because I can tell you're a very loud person. And some people will say that when you call a sin, you're being unloving. And, you know, there's many sins laid out in the Bible, and I'm sure you know what they are. And to call that person's act sinful is loving them, because you're wanting to tell them so that they can repent and be in right standing again with God. Some people are going to say that's unloving, but it's truly loving your neighbor when you care about them.
But I also believe that's the Holy Spirit's job, too.
Yeah. But it says we're to hold each other accountable, doesn't it?
But believers, like, if somebody's not choosing to live under the law of the Lord, then you can't hold them to the same standard.
Yeah. I think
they're not going to come to God if all they feel is, like, condemned. You know,
right,
like,
but we have to stand up for this child.
Yeah, that's why I think you guys are awesome for
rescue
doing
those
it.
Being
it's just
led to slaughter.
From, like, what I would do, and that's okay.
Things
like,
he hates is a shedding
of
blood.
It's a different expression
blood.
Of God's heart. Yeah.
So if he hates it,
I do think there is an evil way to fight abortion, and the evil way is to not expose it, to not talk about it, to keep silent until you have an opportunity to find it. Until you have an opportunity to find someone who's going to come and talk to you, like, nobody advertises, hey, I'm going to go kill my baby tomorrow, you know?
Yeah.
It's like usually after they're like, hey, guess what I did? And then you have then you're like, oh.
You know,
it's too
a
late.
Very powerful thing is prayer. And you can spend so much time down on your knees in prayer, and God will come through.
Sure.
He can use the Holy Spirit to come to a person and convict them, not condemn them, but have them change their mind about something they might be choosing to do.
Right.
So
how do you feel about us being his hands and feet?
Yeah.
Yeah, which we go out and pray for people and love them, give them hugs.
Hands and feet are action words. Besides, prayer is an action, but hands and feet actually physically touch somebody.
That's so funny.
So being the hands and feet is an action. It's actually being out helping the people, getting in touch with them somehow. There's a way to do it. The other thing too that you said, you know, the Holy Spirit convicts. If I am walking in this oneness of the Lord under His Spirit, then the Holy Spirit is going to be speaking through me. His words will be. It is up to me, not up to me. I'm supposed to be under the headship of Christ, so that He can work through me, and I can then be the hands and feet, right? So that's when you talk about Holy Spirit conviction. That's what I would say. We all, as Christians, need to walk and be willing to let Him use us. If we keep our mouth shut,
so I guess we will be on our way, but we just want you guys to know we love you, and we know you love, and we are very thankful for the way you love children.
Awesome.
Bless you guys.
Thanks, guys. Hey, don't forget the red letter challenge. Make sure you're following the right Jesus. There's only one. I'm serious. Might be surprised.
You just have no idea who we are.
Well, who are we?
Who are we?
Oh, I'm sorry. Wait a minute.
Do we need autographs?
What?
We are daughters of God.
Yeah.
Huh?
We are daughters of God.
But I understand.
Bless you guys. You guys are awesome.
I know. There's a fake
night,
Jesus
okay?
being promoted.
Who's this fake Jesus?
I call him Fuzzy Wuzzy Jesus.
Fuzzy Wuzzy Jesus.
He's the guy that does it. Have you read Isaiah 63? Read Isaiah 63. Okay. That's Jesus that we're going to meet. We should be preparing to meet him.
Yeah.
Isaiah 63.
I don't know Jesus.
Church just can't fight because it's asleep in the light. How can you be so dead when and you've been so well fed. Jesus rose from the grave, and you can't even get out of bed. Oh, Jesus rose from the dead. Mess, come away with me, my love.